Hello everyone, this is not the video that I was supposed to be uploading right now. If you didn't know, I have a like page on Facebook for this YouTube channel just to let you guys know when I upload and to post things that I don't think belong on the channel but are still involved with what I do. I made a post recently about an adventure that I was going to be going on where I was going to be flying down to Texas for the LoneStar JZX90 event. If you don't know anything about that event, it was pretty much just like a drift day with a competition down at the Houston Police Academy, where the winner of the competition actually wins a JZX90 provided by Aaron Losey. I actually have a lot of friends down in Texas that I'm friends with because of a set of Corsa. I met them online. I've been playing with them for a year or so. And I've always wanted to go down there to meet them in real life and also to see how Lone Star events are and how Aaron runs them. I've always wanted to go to a Lone Star event because I feel like that's definitely one of the better events in the US and that it's very well ran. I've always wanted to be able to meet all my friends and also to be able to just see what the environment is down in Texas. I had the flights booked. I was going to be staying with my buddy Mike and everything was ready to go. But the day before I was supposed to leave was my work's Christmas party. They threw this big fancy banger at some place in St. Louis and I was going to go there, drink, have a good time. The next morning at 3 a.m. I had to leave to go to the airport to fly to Houston. The plan was kind of just to drink and stay up and then get on the plane and go. Well, an hour and a half before my flight, I fell asleep. I had an alarm set, but I still slept through it. By the time I woke up, it was too late for their flat tire policy to where you're able to switch your flight and still get out that day. So I ended up screwed. I had no way to get down there, I just had to call it all off. It definitely made my weekend pretty shit, and I was pretty down and kicking myself about it because this is something I've been planning for a while and something that I was very excited for. And on top of that, things just haven't been going the greatest, so this is gonna be kind of my pick-me-up. But ever since then, things just keep going to shit. So this video is kind of just me updating you on everything, and I kind of wanted to straighten things up about that because I knew there were people that had questions about it. So on that Facebook page, I'm going to try to link it in the description. I'm going to forget. I made a big post on there about the adventure I was going on, and I still haven't even posted on it saying that I didn't go. I still wanted to upload something because I felt like I haven't uploaded in a while, and there was enough things that have happened to where I can update you guys on it. So on the start of the shit list that's been going on, if you didn't know, I daily drive a 92 Lexus LS400. That thing's just pissing me off. It has just been going to shit. There's been multiple things wrong with it, and it just keeps having issues that I just feel like I'm dumping so much money into. And right now it has a weird problem where it won't rev past a certain RPM, and I've swapped out so many things, and if I just keep dumping money into it, I feel like it's just gonna be a waste. So the only other car I have to get to work and back is my 240. If you didn't know, my 240 also has a Lexus 1UZ in it, so it's pretty reliable but also questionable because there's a lot of swap parts that you don't know how long they're supposed to last. The car's also, you know, has a big body kit, big wheels, low to the ground, and all that other stuff, so it makes the drive kind of hard. I actually live in Illinois, but I have to cross the river to go over to Missouri to work in downtown St. Louis, so the roads are pretty shit and the drive is like an hour long and sucks in the 240, but it's my only vehicle, so I have to do it. So I have changed a few things on the car to make it a little more daily drivable. I'll show you real quick.
First thing I did was put this S14 seat in for the driver's seat. I normally use a bride rep, but that thing just destroys my back on this drive, so I picked this up from a buddy super cheap. But it'll be in the car until drift season comes back up, but until then it's comfy. I also raised the car up. I'll try to insert a picture of what it used to look like. It doesn't look like much, but it's definitely, fuck. It doesn't look too crazy, but still, it has made the drive so much easier because it was pretty low with how low the body kit is. I don't know if I showed you, but I welded this tooth onto my stock bash bar. I thought it was cute as shit.
And of course, just other small little things have just kind of been stacking up on top of that, making these past few weeks pretty shit. One of them being I broke a fucking tooth, one of the back ones. And if you ever have had tooth problems, you know it fucking sucks and it makes everything shit. And of course, there's other things on top of that that I'm not gonna get into, but I'm trying to keep my head up on this and trying to just get through it and just wait for spring to get here because it is fucking cold outside and I don't have any motivation to do anything. So since I have to daily drive the 240 and that I'm low on money, I'm not really able to modify the car and make videos on it. So that's why the channel's been slow. hopefully once I get a daily driver, I can get some content out of that, and also I can start spending some money on the 240 and trying to make it look a little prettier before next drift season. Because I'm trying to get the car painted and new decals put on, but by the way it looks, I don't know if it's going to happen. One thing that I've always wanted to do is make Lift for Speed and like a set of Corsa videos, and also stream. The PC that I have is actually pretty old, and it does struggle when it comes to using OBS and playing a video game, but hopefully with this tax season rolling around, I can get a better PC and start recording those things. I definitely feel like that would be really fun to do, and I feel like a lot of people are entertained by seeing how people go from real life drifting into simulation drifting and seeing the differences, and also it's just fun. It's gonna be a long time before drift events start popping up again, because we are about mid-December right now, and we don't start doing events until about March. And that really sucks, because I really do want this channel to pick up. And I really do want to start building viewers and start building this channel into better entertainment. Because I spend a lot of time on YouTube. I spend a shit ton of time. It is my life, pretty much. As much as I don't upload, I am viewing every single day. And that's all I do at work, pretty much, is just watch YouTube videos. And one video that I've been thinking about doing is a who I subscribe to and why. But that would of course be the car YouTubers that I follow to stay in the right type of content with my channel. That's kind of been something I've been sitting on for when I don't have anything else to film, and that might be my next video. And I feel like it'd be really interesting, because I'm able to show you guys channels that you've never probably seen before and help boost them up and kind of show the people that don't watch a lot of car channels like a good direction to follow when it comes to just cars or just drifting. So I have a lot of thinking to do when it comes to trying to make content this winter, because I'm not doing a full rebuild or doing anything like I did last winter. So it's going to be a struggle, but I hope you guys stick around and enjoy what I do end up making. Oh, mullet update. You guys don't normally watch my videos. I've been growing a mullet. And last time, it was not there. It was shit compared to now. It's been a while since I've uploaded last, and it's fucking grown.
I don't know how well you're able to see this,
but holy fuck, this thing has gotten long. I look fucking retarded. Oh, and at that Christmas party, I had to be in a full suit. How the fuck are you supposed to look good in a full suit with a mullet? That's all that I have to say. I hope you guys enjoyed a little bit of an update of what's been going on in my life, and I hope you guys stick around for the winter, because I have a good feeling that next summer is going to be fucking crazy, because I'm going to try to network and travel as much as I can, because I want to start making a lot of friends in the community and really explore what all goes on in drifting in the US. But thank you guys for watching, and I will see you next time.